we cannot forget about this probiotic benefit and immunological benefits of probiotics. They enhance our digestion. They alter the pH of the intestine to suppress the growth of pathogens. Also, some studies are saying they release certain chemicals which can kill the pathogens. So eating foods rich in probiotics and prebiotics influences the brain behavior. They lower the stress, they lower the anxiety, they lower the depression. So first of all, we must know the difference between probiotics and prebiotics. Probiotics are the live organisms which are present in our food and they are beneficial for the host. Prebiotics are the food components which enhances the growth of live organisms, the growth of healthy bacteria inside the gut. So probiotics and prebiotics, we have so many food sources to get all these in our diet. So here we have listed the probiotic foods and prebiotic foods. Let's discuss them one by one. First is the yogurt. The packed dahi may not have all the kind of live organisms in it. So we are talking about the homemade curd. Include homemade curd, a katori of curd in everyday routine to get a good dose of probiotics. Carrot kanji is our traditional drink, which is made up of fermented carrot with some spices that also has some probiotic effects on our body. Rabdi of barley flour. This is a traditional recipe from Haryana in Rajasthan, in which the barley flour is cooked, fermented with some yogurt, and then eaten as a breakfast or as a lunch. So this is also rich in probiotics. Overnight soaked rice. In some states of Bengal and South India, people are eating overnight soaked rice in the morning for the probiotic effect of these rice. Kombucha tea, kimchi, fermented milk like Yakult, Dhokla. Dhokla is a Gujarati snack and also it is fermented. During the fermentation process, the chemical changes are coming in the food, which makes them easy to digest and they are good to promote the healthy bacteria in our gut. Idli, dosa, kadhi and homemade pickles also a good source of probiotics. Commercial preparation of pickle is not a good source of probiotics as they are loaded with preservatives and other chemicals. So we are talking about homemade pickles. Although they are rich in sodium, but again, they are good probiotics. So you have to take in moderation for their benefits. If taken in excess, pickles can also harm your health. About the prebiotics, the foods which are helping our beneficial bacteria to feed. One is the chicory root. Chicory root, you must have heard about the coffee. It is actually added to the coffee. Chicory root has a compound which is called inulin, which is works as a prebiotic. Chicory root powder is being added to the commercial preparations of coffee also. So next time when you look for the coffee, add a coffee which is being added with 30-40% of chicory root powder, because it has the same kind of flavor as a normal coffee has. Raw banana is another source of prebiotics because it is rich in resistant starch. All foods which are rich in resistant starch is a good source of prebiotics. It is very easy to incorporate in our diet. We can make sabzi out of it, or we can make healthy snacks out of raw banana. Raw garlic. Popping a pod of raw garlic in the morning, either one or two, is also helping us in maintaining the gut flora. Wheat bran. Wheat bran also have resistant starch. That is why it is included in prebiotics. But that doesn't mean you buy a packet of wheat bran and you start adding into your chapatis. We are talking about the whole wheat. We have to consume the whole grains to have the wheat bran, not the only packet of wheat bran. Barley. Traditionally, we were using barley in place of wheat. So barley is another source of prebiotics. Raw honey is also a very good source of prebiotics. We are not talking about pasteurized honey. Many commercial preparations are selling pasteurized honey. Pasteurized honey will not work as a prebiotic. It's only raw, pure, and organic honey will work. Germinated pulses means sprouts. When we make sprouts out of pulses, the content of resistant starch in them increases, which work as prebiotic when we take them. So all these sources are very easy sources, very good sources to include in our routine for the improvement of gut flora inside. We have a wide variety of foods which acts as prebiotic and probiotic, but we need to put effort to include them as a part of our regular diet.